now I'm in a place where I know exactly how much money I want to manifest and create for myself.
For
and
now.
I'm just not sure that...
For now.
In this, right, for now. And I'm just now exploring ways to get there.
Well, you know how you made the definition that rather than being bold, what did you decide to be instead of bold?
Joyful.
Joyful. And in the joyfulness, there's a receptivity. So rather than trying to figure out how to accomplish the more money, all you got to do is figure out how to be more joyful in the moment. Because in your joy, and therefore in your relaxation of resistance, then the impulses will come to you. And sometimes an impulse that comes does not even seem remotely, even though it is, related to the outcome that you're seeking. But it's leading you to something that leads 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 you to something. And then suddenly it all clicks in for you and you say, oh, now I see. Esther says, on nearly a daily basis, I got this thought and I just let it flow, and it led to another thought, none of them all that precise about anything that I think I'm looking for, but one thought leads to another, and all of a sudden I'm standing in this garden of creation with all of the things that I've been asking for recently about a specific subject just being handed to me. Suddenly you're standing with money all around your ankles, and you want to say, who knew that the happy garden would lead to the peaceful garden, would lead to the garden of more intention? Who knew that what I always thought was laziness and what I always thought was not focusedness, who knew that this ease and flow would lead to everything that I'm looking for? But that's how it works. And so I'm just looking for joy wherever I can find it. And then it's leading to joyful, joyful, joyful things that are specifically relating to my hands in the clay, witnessing of avalanches of money. Then saying, you know, the world is awash in money. You know that, don't you? The world is awash in money. All we got to do is get in sync with the avalanche. How do you do that? You have a plan for that? Yeah. I could just be happy. Test it out and see what happens. But there's more to the story than just get happy. We'll tell you the little bit of the story that we left out just now. You've been living and living and living and living and living and knowing what you don't want and knowing what you do want. And you've been filling up your vortex has been spinning and spinning. The law of attraction has been responding to it, and your inner being has been standing there as a point of attraction. And all cooperative components have been gathered. So everything you want is a vibrational reality. We left that part out just now. There's a vibrational reality that is ready for you. The question is, are you ready for it? And the answer is, when you're working too hard, no. The answer is, when you're having fun, you're ready for a piece of it, and you're ready for another piece of it, and you're ready for another piece of it. But you gotta chill in order to get into the receptive mode to know what to do and what to do and what to do and what to do and what to do. Those impulses are gonna come from within, and those impulses are gonna provide perfect timing. So here it is. This vortex that we are just describing to you, You're really going to like this. This vortex that we're describing to you, every piece of it, every piece of this vibrational reality has a physical counterpart. So all of the cooperative components and peoples and agencies and changes in laws, all of those pieces of your vortex have physical, flesh, blood, and bone, real life counterparts. So your inner being knows every single one of them that match every single one of those. Your inner being knows exactly what you want and how to help you get it. So all you have to do is tune in to what your vortex, in essence, knows. And to your degree of happiness, which is the same thing as saying to your degree of readiness, your timing in the rendezvousing with all of those manifestations will occur. That's how thoughts turn to things. And so when you tune in, then you'll know when to move forward. You'll know what to say when. You'll just sense, because your inner being knows. Talk about a coaching system. Talk about having a friend upstream. Talk about having not necessarily the most direct route to what you want, but certainly the most happy route to what you want. After just a little bit of this, you'll come to know that nothing is off limits. Nothing is off limits. Every idea that you have, and especially those that you're able to now verbalize, they're ready for you. Let the non-physical you guide the physical you to the other physical yous, so that all the physical yous can have the party that your non-physical yous have already been having.
I'm kind of new to meditating, so I'm hoping for some kind of technique that can maximize my potential as a person, as well as help me get more in touch with my inner being.
We really like your words here, because there is no better understanding about maximizing myself as a person than to understand that it is connecting myself to my whole self. Allowing the whole of me to be present in this moment. What your objective is, and an easy way that we know of to hook up. Offer in a moment in time that you've chosen. Set aside 15 or 20 minutes. Earlier in the day, the better. Quiet your mind to the point of no resistance, so that in the absence of resistance, your vibration rises, it will, just like a cork floating to the surface. And as your vibration rises, you vibrationally tune in to the frequency of your inner being, and that's what alignment is. So meditation is the path to alignment. It's a tool to the path to alignment. It's interesting. It just means stop the normal thought to allow the internal thought or the inner being thought. You're not focusing, you're allowing a more important focus. What you're actually saying is, I'm setting this time aside to clear a space in me so that my inner being can flow through me clearly. This is a distinction that we really want you to hear. Your inner being is always flowing to you and through you. Always. You don't need to meditate to allow us to see through your eyes or hear through your ears or taste through your tongue. In other words, we're there all the time. But it is necessary for you to recognize that it's happening. But if within 15 or 20 minutes you can really relax into non-thought until you can actually feel that detachment, we want to say that feeling of detachment is key to knowing you're accomplishing a significant meditation. That difference in the way your body feels. Even better, once you've received that sense of detachment, if you receive an impulse to move and you know you're not directing it, even better. That means you've come into alignment with your inner being, who knows every cell of your body and who is offering impulses so that your body will respond to the intentionality of the thought that's being offered. You just get so you can feel that attunement or not, that attunement or not. And after a little while, you'll be so in tune that you'll begin to receive thoughts that your inner being is thinking. And because you've already practiced what it feels like to be in tune, you'll know those thoughts are the thoughts of your inner being because you'll feel the attunement that you've been practicing when there were no thoughts. You want to be actively involved with your mind. Your mind is your creative mechanism. Your mind is the way you focus energy. And focus upon the unconditioned, which is what we are wanting to call today the emotional. So let's say that you've decided that you could use an extra $10 million. Oh, you'll get that easily, but we're talking about right away. We're talking about regularly, monthly. We're We're talking about a lot of financial remuneration coming your way. So let's say you've decided that you want that. And let's say that you spend a little time thinking about it. So you've got that desire in place. So if you're looking for that $10 million today, you could, if you were willing to be unconditional in your creation, you could find a feeling of prosperity. You could acknowledge what having abundance feels like. You could remember moments of feeling prosperous. You could find a feeling of well-being. Or you could remember having seen something that made you feel that way. And you could accomplish right now. In 1 minute or 2 minutes or 5 minutes, you could accomplish in this day the unconditioned, the vibration that matches the unconditioned of that abundance. And you could accomplish right now. And if you do that and you do that often, then it is our absolute promise to you that that manifestation must come into your experience and relatively quickly. That manifestation must come into your experience and relatively quickly. Because you will have done what almost nobody does. You will have held the vibration of your desire and no longer contradicted it by facing reality. You see how that works? If you just heard that, you have just captured for yourself the key to accomplishing, to being, or doing, or having anything that you desire. And if you do that and you do that often, that manifestation must come into your experience and relatively quickly. We know who you are. We know what you're asking for. We know it. We see it. We see where it is. We see where you are in relationship to it. And every word we speak is about helping you to achieve a vibrational stance that allows what you have created to flow easily to you. I'm living happily ever after, and the universe is yielding to me on so many fronts. And I really believe that whatever I want on any subject can come to me. And there's evidence of what I'm wanting coming to me in many, many ways. And I'm looking forward to the discovery of more and more avenues through which well-being can flow to me. And I'm certain that I have all kinds of desire that is lined up for me, that's in my vortex, that's being yielded to me. And I believe that the universe is yielding more to me than I'm maybe even able to receive. And I'm getting better and better at receiving it. And I really like this other stuff that I'm doing. And I really like understanding the laws of the universe. And I'm always looking for opportunities where I can help other people see that how the laws of the universe are working too. Now we're going to get a little more specific. And you see, if in getting more specific, you're still in that easy place. And I like the idea of being a deliberate creator, and I so like deliberately creating among others who are deliberately creating. It is so much fun to watch the universe bring to me the cooperative components of what I'm looking for. The universe knows who I am and what I want relative to all topics. What life is, and what the thrill of life is being on that brink of the next explosion into your mind. The next realization of this big thought, this big knowing, this big understanding, this big manifestation. Bigger manifestation. Manifest, 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 manifest. Bigger, 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 bigger. Don't you love being alive? Aren't you glad you're in your body?